Dire team ban. Seconds remaining.
No.
Radiant team ban.
I'm back. Sorry. Just a glass of H2O. OP hero. Still OP hero. Maybe just a little bit too strong at the right hand.
Remaining.
The hero just does so much. The hero.
5 seconds remaining. Reserve time. Radiant team pick.
Oh yeah. 2500. That was level 6.
Seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Beastmaster.
Dire team pick.
Which is also a very solid pick.
Dark Seer.
Radiant team pick.
Everyone's picking Dark Seer so much, yeah? I don't see so much of like Tide of Phoenix. Like in the Epicenter games, I see a lot of like Phoenix openings, Tide.
10 seconds remaining.
Like I even see Batriders a lot, but not so much Dark Seer.
5 seconds remaining.
Yeah, but then, you know what is my issue with the hero right now? He has no tempo. Like, his tempo is teamfight. And he's all about the lane, you know? He don't do well in the lane. I mean, he's great because you can farm jungle. That's why he's good in the first 10 minutes. In terms of talking about an offlaner. But since the introduction of Iron Talon, any offlaner can jungle.
10 seconds remaining.
I'm not to say taken away, but everyone has it.
5 seconds remaining.
Yeah.
Reserve time.
Now it's not only small gangs, it's like the big gangs. Like when you get a blink on a certain hero, but like I always talk about first 10 minutes, usually the hero that has the most tempo. That's why that's always banned a lot, is Doom and Bounty Hunter. And Earth Spirit. These are the three heroes that provide the most potential tempos in the first 10 minutes so that other tempos can come into play. Radiant usually it's like that. Ban. The support makes the tempo first and then it's your mid lane like a Puck level 6 comes ban. Into play and then he's gonna TP to the off lane or your carry like Juggernaut or Gyro. You have ultimate, you're level 7, you TP to the off lane, you get a kill, you help your off lane get to his tempo which Radiant is the blink in most ban. Cases or Beastmaster, Necrobook. Those are the type of plays that you can make with all these type of heroes but when you don't have those type of heroes, like what happened in the last game, when I was talking about AA's lineup, then you are just merely sitting in your lane and waiting for the big item, and you're waiting for a team fight, and you just allow your team, the enemy's team, to actually dictate everything, which is bad in my opinion for the current meta.
10 seconds remaining.
No.
Vengeful spirit.
Radiant team pick.
Situational, like it can be really good, like what you said, like if the team, like when you're playing against Miracle's team, and you know he's the guy that's going to, you know, roll you over, and you take a lot of farm, then you just pick a Lich to sit in his lane, but that might not even be that great of an idea after post 10-15 minutes, right? Like what I said about the hero.
Radiant team pick.
Yeah. Abed plays a really good Mirana. He understands the hero's strength and he's always like this hero is a lot of there's a lot of things that he provides for his team. Like first is the tempo, like you get level 6, level 7, you're so strong, you have so much nuke. he's not very good in a lane because
5 seconds remaining.
You don't have great damage or good animation compared to Queen of Pain, but he provides a lot
Reserve
in terms of
time.
For the team later. You don't need to wait for a big cooldown. Like Queen of Pain is always about, oh, we have that one big sonic wave and then 2 minutes you have to wait. But for Mirana, you don't have to do that. Your ultimate is like a great way of using it as a smoke as well. So I feel like Mirana provides more in terms of tempo compared to Queen. Queen is like one big tempo, but Mirana doesn't need to wait for the big cooldown.
Juggernaut.
Dire team ban.
He's not greedy, but he's strong late game as well. Like this hero, you want to have like all-rounded. Like right now, the Dota is about being all-rounded. Good in the lane, good in team fights. You know, can be greedy. You can play him as a very greedy Juggernaut depending on your build. You can be played as a fighting Juggernaut.
Remaining.
You get all the small items like what Jayo did. Yasha, drums, and then you fight. So the
Reserve
hero is very
time.
Flexible. Nah, not much. It's all about scaling. Some strats have a tower taking potential early, but they are able to switch because they have a very big lead. But I don't see a specific lineup designed to just breach very early. It's more about outplaying and then you get that advantage. You have that all-rounded draft, you have that draft that scales very well. But then because you're outplaying the enemy, so that's why you're pushing the high ground so quickly. They fight very well, yeah. Mm-hmm. Dragonite? You like Dragonite? Then the Mirana will be safe lane if they do that. Because right now I see them needing a melee hero that can be an Iron Shell target, a tanky hero, so that would be nice for them.
10 seconds remaining. Radiant team ban.
I like Dragonite more. Because Dragonite can, you know, because you were talking about the tower, like sieging powers, like Dragonite provides more. Razor's more like a lane dominator, you know. You win your lane. You focus a lot on winning the lane.
10 seconds remaining.
Yeah, but then
seconds remaining.
The issue is like about how to transition. I think helping to in terms of transitioning and
Reserve
having more
time.
In like scaling, I think Dragonite would provide more. I just like the hero more, and he
Radiant
buys armlet, which is the
pick.
Flavor of the month. Whatever you want to say, flavor of the patch, flavor of the month.
Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
If they want to be greedy, Beastmaster can be their jungling hero.
Reserve time.
So that option is still open for them. But if they are looking for a support, yeah, I do like a roaming support. I really do like a roaming support now. But there's not much available, yeah. Earth Spirit, there's Tusk, there's still Tusk. Tusk is the last one. The last one available. What else? Roaming hero. There's no Mirana, there's no... Like, all the main ones are already banned out. Maybe they were also deciding because of that they would just put Beastmaster as a greedy hero and then run another offlaner. Like a greedy support and then run another offlaner. Yeah, if actually they do that, they can have the nice soccer Beastmaster map control. Map control heroes. That would be nice too. Yeah, I like that idea. Then Night Stalker, you could run Night Stalker as your greedy jungler and Beastmaster on the lane. Vice versa. Depending on how you want it. Personally, I would like I would think that Beastmaster jungle a lot faster, and I will put my stalker on
10 seconds
offlane.
remaining.
But then it's the same thing, right?
Five
Beastmaster is also
seconds
very good in the
remaining.
lane compared to that.
Dire team pick.
It's very good in the lane, like with the Juggernaut. Right now, because they don't have Temple, but they traded it for better lanes.
Ten
So their lane is really
remaining.
strong. Disruptor, Queen, and Rubick. I mean, Rubick can somewhat create some Temple
Five
early, because when
remaining.
You roam, you lift into the Queen of Pain. Has some sort of kill potential, but that's the last hero for the Iron Shell. Pierre. Much more scaling. This is much stronger than a DK in terms of scaling into late game. Because if you go Dragonite Mirana, means your late game is not very good compared to what Mineski have, because they have Juggernaut. So PL will somewhat equalize that. You can deal. I wonder if they will actually put PL. They're gonna put PL mid. Nendo is the mid player. So PL against Queen, it's very difficult for Rubick to gank PL. So if you talk about the Rubick's tempo, it's more like winning your lane, and then you wait for Juggernaut to get level 6, or Queen of Pain level 6. And then you rotate and you move with this one of those two heroes to the Beastmaster's lane to kill the carry. And then Disruptor will take the safe lane experience. So that's what you want to do. Prioritize on giving more lane to Disruptor to get XP. Rubick will want to roam, but not alone, with a Queen of Pain or Juggernaut.
5 seconds remaining.
With the PL pick, because Dragonite would have more tempo despite not having better scaling. PL means they have to be a bit more defense, a bit more farm orientated. They can roam and kill heroes if PL gets a good rune, but they can't really siege towers that well. They will have the same issue that they had yesterday. Remember the game where they can't siege because of their lineup? So they will have that problem in this game too, but they are going to rely on getting their PL and Mirana super farmed. They are very good heroes of pushing out the lanes later, because Mirana is going to get Aghanim's, right? And Darkseid is going to push lanes with Iron Shell. So they have that going on for them. They are very mobile. They push out all the lanes very easily with their 3 cores. But then, you know, in this type of game, Witch Doctor as a support doesn't do too much. He's only there for the laning phase, because when you are split pushing, Venge is okay, but Witch Doctor is not going to do so much. They have Beastmaster, so Vision will be on their side if they place the Hulks appropriately. So that's going to be good for them. And overall, I feel like because of the Vision advantage, and if they... I will still say that I favor Mineski's lanes more. I think their lanes are better overall. So they have Juggernaut and Queen, so I would say that the mid lane and the safe lane, like Darkseid is not going to get too much from the off lane because of the three heroes, and mid lane will be Queen of Pain favored. But Queen of Pain
begins.
Is not going mid. Dude, he's going safe lane.
We'll
Jug is going mid? Oh yeah, I just realized who is playing the Jug. So Darkseid is not even going to be bottom. Oh. Wait, Teams is playing Venge. So R is I thought R was a support player and he only plays the offlane if there's Earth Spirit. Okay, no. Everything is permanently switched now. R is the offlane player. His name is Ralph Richard, just so if you wanna know. R. Yeah, Ralph Richard. And everyone else. So Rubick is gonna get the D ward here. gonna get that nice 100 gold reimbursement for the sentry. And looking at other lanes, it's gonna be Beastmaster versus Darkseer 1v1. So it's gonna be very good for Execration, because Darkseer is gonna get more. And this tri-lane game we mentioned yesterday, you don't see teams do it enough with Mirana picks. Because with Mirana, you can pressure the enemy safe lane a lot. But since it's a queen, then it doesn't allow them to get as much advantage compared to a melee hero like Juggernaut. Disruptor run up and tank the arrow.
First blood. What is this? I came here to be tested.
Lucky shot.
Spell my doom.
Triple kill.
Why you don't believe me? I told you he's gonna run up and tank the arrow. Yeah, he actually did. That was really unfortunate. But I still think it would have been really good for Mineski once the arrow got blocked by Disruptor, because they spread out the damage and then his lift. And he lifted one of the heroes and he stunned the other two when they dropped down. So that was like, the fight was over after that. They took way too much damage. I'm not sure. But you know how times have changed now? It's PL versus Juggernaut mid. How often do we get to see that? My god. Then you pick Tide, Axe for mid lanes. I think if Darkseer played, I mean the lane right now is really good for Beastmaster, he's even against Darkseer. I don't think that should be the case. If Darkseer plays this matchup correctly, he should always be farming more than the Beastmaster. It shouldn't be even. Yeah, it shouldn't be even. It should never be even. Beastmaster, however, will be able to have chances to kill the Darkseer once he has level 6. That's when it gets tricky for Darkseer. So as long as he plays safe after that, you push the lane in jungle. And you don't stay too close when you don't see supports on the map. Oh, we got a leap. Our bat has no leap. He's dead. We're gonna try to deny him.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
So this offensive tri-lane definitely not working out because they were not expecting Queen of Pain to be down here. Nah, it's fine. We might get the lift. No boots. Yes, spin soon. No mana, is it? No, he has mana. Oh, he has to stick for the mana. Okay. He lost the kill. I mean, I expected Mineski to have better laning phase, but not by such a big margin. Okay, this bench has to get a kill somewhere else. So mid lane difficult because it's Juggernaut. Top lane Beastmaster. I don't know, man. It's difficult. He's too low level. It's level 2. Man, how is this?
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Yeah, away from the creeps. That was a very good play. Yeah. But then, I'm not sure how this Beastmaster is getting so much. He's not supposed to get so much from against Darkseer. Why is he ahead of the Darkseer? I don't think the Darkseer is playing his matchup correctly. Now it's gonna be a Raw.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
The man of the moment. One roam towards middle, netted a kill. One roam towards top, netted a kill. And the other kills all came from bottom lane. That's the dream of the support. You kill your lane, you roam mid, you kill mid, you roam top, you kill top. And then you tell your team, I done my job, team. Yeah, Earn is good if you can get it early. I don't think you can say it's bad for Rubik in most cases. Some players might do that, but I like the Earn. Helps your team, helps yourself, helps you get kills, and if no one else is getting the Earn, why not?
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
Damn, he has 51 last. How is he having so much? Oh my god. Like, there's no. There's no way this is happening though. Darkseer should be able to pull ahead in this lane. For sure, at least by like 5 to 10 CS. Most of the time, even more, because as the lane draws out longer, you push out the lane and you jungle. The more you jungle, the more ahead you get against the Beastmaster. This might be a fast game, Lumi, at this rate. Mirana will be the main one, but because she's not having a good time, so it's difficult. Well, they're trying to make a tempo play with the smoke on the two supports, but this is not going to be bad. This is going to be bad because Mineski has, like I mentioned, the Rubik plus one of the Queen or the Jug. Smoke towards the safe lane. Oh, that was big. Oh, that was big for Execration. They had 5 heroes there. They smoked 2 atop. Even though they lost the Darkseid, but the other 2 TP'd so quickly. Did you see like how quick, like the moment they were diving, the Raw wasn't even on him, the TP already came. Yeah, they understood that rotation. It's like they were hitting top as well. They read it for Mineski. So, yeah, did she not have? I think she went back to base, yeah, because she's at full, or she went for run or something. I don't know. Wasn't. No reason not to be there at that fight, because that would have been huge for her. Nah, not gonna be easy though. Darkseer plus Bench, you don't have that much damage. Oh. The queen is top. Execration. I don't know if they actually read this. Yeah, there was a ward in the lane though. If you look at bottom, there was a deep ward in the lane for Execration. Not sure if he saw, the queen TP, but regardless, she already showed herself. So they already know what's up. And again, Execration making the same play, going towards top with both the supports. But this time, Mineski is only having one hero here.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
Yep, there was like no way they could have gotten that kill. Unless the bench was near enough. But here comes the Beastmaster, he tried to roar.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack. Dire's middle tower is under attack. Radiant's structures are fortified. Dire's middle tower has fallen.
Well, Mineski needs to be able to get towers right now after getting, like, you get the lane advantage, then you want to take out the tier 1 mid and the tier 1 on the safe lane. These are the two most key towers you want to take out. So they've done it in the mid lane. Now they're proceeding to the top tier 1. This will open up the whole jungle for Mineski to invade.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack. Dire's top tower is under attack.
Dude, you were talking about the 15 minute Necrobook. I think we might see it this game. 15 minute level 3. Yeah, look at his farm. He has level 2 Necrobook now. Unless he dies. I told you, you have to have a super good game to have that happen. Yep, that's strange. Whoever with the Necrobook that plays the aura is better. Max aura. For solo killing potential. I mean, it doesn't matter so much since he's so ahead right now. Having the aura or more points in the axe. Dude, he's like taking over the whole game, you know, like this Beastmaster. It shouldn't happen against Dark here. I don't know what happened, I wasn't like looking at the lane all the time. But if, to me, it's like, okay, Dark's a Beastmaster, Dark should be farming more, that's all. Nothing special should happen. It's not only the levels, it's the farm that he has, it's so scary. Doesn't matter. I think you still give it to the support or someone who needs level 11. Like someone who needs an important level. Very, very crucial level. Otherwise, I don't think you give it to Beastmaster.
Necrobook.
Yeah, they're just doing it in the sentry range because that's Mirana. They don't want to be hitting the tower without detection near the tower because of Moonlight Shadow.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
No tempo. That's like what we discussed before. If they don't win the lanes, they don't do well in the lanes, this is gonna happen. Mineski has better catch because of Beastmaster, they have the vision and they have the glimpse. So long range initiation. And now they're pushing out the lanes because they are able to actually force Execration to group up at bottom lane previously. So they're using the map much better right now. Yeah, why not? We talked about that, right? Like the Doom, the Bounty Hunter, the Earth Spirits, the Romers. Oh, bottom lane. He...
My final.
Well, it's gonna help them like recover in terms of farm, but the state of the game will not change still. It's still gonna be the problem of the vision. Beastmaster's gonna control the game. And right now it's already past the timing of the Mirana can dictate play. Because she's supposed to be like killing and running around and ganking like maybe say minute 6 onwards towards minute 15. But right now it's already way past that time.
Radiant's top tower is under attack. Radiant's top tower has fallen.
Yeah, so this game she's not gonna be able to detect this because of what happened in the lane. Okay, 16. 16 is pretty good too. Oh! Oh my god, the PL! The PL saved the day for them! What was going on there? Huh. They did got the Aegis though, so it was one kill plus Aegis. For Beastmaster and Disruptor, but they did get the last hit on Roshan, so it wasn't all disastrous for Mineski. How big was the change in terms of experience? Yeah, this is like the momentum being slowed or broken, so it's very crucial despite them not getting too much out of it.
Dire's middle tower has fallen.
You mean for Execration? So they need the blink on the Beastmaster soon so he can actually get pick off. I think at this stage if he catches the PL out alone, he can even solo kill the PL with the Necro 3 plus Brook, plus the blink.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
Do they have sentries this time? Oh, never mind. They're backing up. Rubik TP's back for sentries. Like, the captain is like, Where is our sentries? The shuttle is like, I'm gonna get my Aetherlands. You get a sentries. Yeah, he's actually fed. He's fun. They Yeah, for the PR in his team situation, he's found. Diffuser plus Yasha plus bots. Only the Beastmaster can lock him down and kill him, since Orchid doesn't work anymore. There's a Diffuser. Yeah, raw Necro books, you burn all his mana and kill him.
Dire's top tower is under attack. Spoil that shot. Dire's structures are fortified. Dire's top tower has fallen.
You know, Beastmaster gets his blink now, so gonna get Vlad's next. They do need a gem though. I think they need a gem. So that this Mirana Ultimus can't be so threatening towards them. It's not up all the time though. I don't think they can rely on it every time.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack. Your hopes? Ignite.
Yeah. Mineski just tried to, you know, sometimes when you retreat, you leave a few heroes to get a pick off. But then there's so many heroes there, so. Oop! He has no TP yet. Oh, they're still gonna try to go in. Here comes the Beastmaster. He has his blink ready. They should be able to get a kill. Yep. Didn't work out the first time, but they tried again and it worked out. So Raging Potato is the only one still there, so he's the one waiting. He was the patient one. Well, he didn't have a TP, so he had nowhere to go. Anyway. So Mineski is just gonna control map. Probably wait for next, most likely wait for next Roshan, and then just out farm the opponent with the. Yeah, could have been so bad. Could have been so bad if they didn't get the Aegis. So. Right now, they just still need the gem. I still insist that they need the gem. They have the blood, everything. I don't think the Beastmaster needs anything else anymore. Should get the gem as soon as he can. Or even get the supports to buy it, since supports are rich. Actually no, supports are poor. Just kidding. So he has to buy it himself. Five-second arrow. Witch Doctor Alti. Oh, good scan. Good scan. Teams are starting to do this a lot more, yeah? When they smoke, they scan at the same time so they know where they are moving. So they know where they should be moving when they don't have wards. Where's their wards though? They're not facing wards yet. Okay, they have one down here. Should be able to guess the enemy's position with the two wards they have.
Yeah.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Next.
You get handed a steak in a silver platter. What more do you want, Louis? Then you are greedy. Okay, ambitious. And being ambitious is a good thing. You know, but Dota 2. It's still the same though now, like, because with the mechanics, with the rubber band mechanics, like, mistakes are much more punishable. Back then it was harder to throw a game, I think, because when you have a big lead, it's very hard for the losing team to come back. Yeah, the battle mobility, map control. It's very hard for you to, like, you have aggregates, but if you can't really move out and farm because of the lack of vision and you're afraid, then it's very hard. So finally the gem comes from the disruptor. This Beastmaster is definitely bullying his supports. He has the goal for it, like, he could easily get the gem.
Radiant's top tower.
The gem is the future.
Attack.
These wards are their saving grace, Lumi. If they remove the two wards, then good luck. Okay, they're gonna rip. Okay, one found.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Well, I think that mentality is not so good though. Like, sometimes someone has to go past, like, push top and push bottom, even if you have to die. Yeah. Oh. So, I mean, sometimes supports can do it, depending on what kind of support you are. Oh, that ward.
Dire structures are fortified.
No, this Rubik is starving.
Worthy tribute.
...70% healing over 7 seconds.
Yeah.
Well, you think about it, how are you getting it as a support now, though? Like how? Okay. You know there's only one way you can do that with the alchemist. They got the kills, the big kills, because they lost ages. He didn't get in range for the defuser. Yeah, he didn't get in range for that. But they still got two towers though, like a mid tier 1. Now they're gonna get a tier 2 at bottom. So that's pretty good for Execration considering everything. Man, the kill steals, man, this is big. He really wants his aggrims. Yeah, it is.
Radiant's bottom tower.
Oh yeah, you get that. Shit, yeah.
A gift from the Tempest of
Holy battle. Shit, that's actually so sick. If you get that, I didn't think of it. Oh my god. The dream. Oh, okay, okay. You have to turn the ultimate on. Oh shit. This is actually... And then you can control your hero even when you die. Shit. X, this game.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
You think he needs some help? The hero's fine. No, the hero's fine though. And the middle part, I wouldn't say so much of a weak side. Like, average hero. You have to pick him in a specific lineup though, like against... But Alliance don't really do that. When they pick Rubick, it's just they want to pick a support or whatnot.
Worthy tribute.
Shadow Bait Beastmaster, yeah? So you can... No, so he can kill the PL. Because he tried so many times to blink roll the PL. Every time PL gets doppelganger, you notice. No, I'm not checking the other game. Lol.
Shadows take us.
Oh, Execration always have all these really good ideas of coming in from behind. Saw it a few times yesterday already. Part of winning the combat is the surprise factor and the positioning. Getting into a better position. Yeah. Maledict!
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
Oh my god. And oh my god, Mando is getting. Oh crap, what is happening? Oh, he might get the roar off if he can actually get into range. Necrobo. Oh, this guy, you know he was the pug, remember the pug game that we casted? Dude. I told you there's always a way. Dota 2. Now they get Roshan. Oh my god, this is like a full comeback soon. This is like a half comeback already. Okay, comeback is real. They're just gonna win the game off this as well. Should be able to get. They can get the top Rex and the top melee. And if they get the melee Rex here, they can leave the range and go for the top melee. Yeah, that's two set of Rex.
Dire's top tower is under attack. Radiant's bottom has fallen. Radiant's top tower has fallen.
Ruby can complain about his team now, right?
Invisibility.
Yeah, this is like the risk of like running a lineup like this when you make a mistake. It's great when you control everything, but it's really bad when you make a mistake. Two in a row, which is already bad. In most cases, after one, you're like, okay, we have to be careful. Yeah, let's chill, and then they do it again, so... I mean, the second one was because they were contesting the Roche, so that wasn't really... I mean, after they killed the PL, maybe they should have just let the PL, because PL was like TPing, you know, when they saw the PL, he was TPing away in the pit. If they were to actually roar the other heroes on the left and just let the PL TP away and kill his teammates, that would have maybe been a better decision in hindsight. That's definitely not English, okay. Don't you know some already? What's the move?
Radiant's middle tower has fallen.
Draw the PL, silence the Venge with Queen. Sounds about right. And then get the Omni Slash on him. They need to get like the kinetic field on top of the raw target so they can't force stuff in away. Just to kill him, why not? That is actually about as good as it gets for Mineski. Yep. They dropped all their big scouts on the first two targets, the bench plus the dark sphere. And PL was just free to kill everyone after that. If they have to, I think the only way they can kill him is to save the raw, just for the PL. If they raw anyone else, then PL is gonna just kill everyone after. They need to control him, that is the problem now. They don't have a hex on anyone. So they only have like raw. Raw into Static Storm Kinetic Shield.
Worthy tribute.
Judge. I can tell you're trying. What? Oh, I'm not sure if the Davids would be too happy about that. No, you don't care about their feelings when you said that.
Out of my way.
No, they don't. You're serious. I'm gonna tell them you're actually serious about that. cool item on Mirana. Pretty cool. Pretty cool if you put it on the PL, yeah? he might want to please put the Lincolns on the PL, then the PL would just run in and kill everyone.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
Just waiting for the next Roshan. Then they should be able to finish the game after that. Good. His final item. Do you still go Abyssal on the hero now? You give the Aegis to someone else, don't you? You take the Aegis and you eat Moonshard. Okay, that's the plan.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack. Radiant's top
smoke. The smoke, you know, they're really good at using their smokes to position themselves for defense or fights. That's what I noticed for this team, Execration. That was what caught them off guard, you know, see. Yeah, that first fight, they got the team wipe, not team wipe, but they killed 4 heroes and then they got Roshan.